Thank you everyone for joining today's CoLab. We hope that this presentation will be useful for your work. The presentation will start with a brief overview of the ALFA project and followed by tutorials to access the data. The goal of the ALFA project is to improve our understanding of human sequence variation by providing a more complete catalog of common and clinical variation, including mutations and their allele frequency, to facilitate variant research and interpretation. To accomplish that goal, ALFA will be combining the vast amount of dbGaP data that includes millions of subjects, billions of variants, and trillions of genotypes. The approach combines aggregate data from multiple dbGaP studies with genotype data. It can provide some significant advantages, including decreased study bias due to platform or variant detection methods. We can evaluate the consistency or inconsistency of the results across multiple datasets and with existing projects such as 1000 Genome, NOMAD, and TopMed. It also provides a more comprehensive coverage of the genome and variants to detect more common and rare variants. ALFA is an ongoing project and will recalculate allele frequency de novo as more data sets become available in dbGaP and from other large data sets from future collaborations. Thus, ALFA data will continue to grow with novel variants and data for underrepresented population with subsequent releases. ALFA's first release went public a few months ago. The input included 42 dbGaP studies and 98,000 subjects with half a trillion genotypes. Running this through the ALFA pipeline resulted in almost half a billion unique variants, with 99% clustering to existing dbSNP variants and 1% novel. The second release will be coming out soon, with double the numbers of studies, subjects, and genotypes. ALFA data are provided as open access from the FAIR data principles. Data is findable for both human and computer through NCBI resources, including dbSNP and TrackHub, and soon ClinVar. Data is accessible through the web, API, and FTP download. The data is normalized and provided in a standard exchangeable format for interoperability. The data is also integrated with dbSNP release and can be reused by existing pipelines that use dbSNP. And lastly, the data is open access and can be reused with no restrictions. Additional information can be found on the project page. To get there, you can search for NCBI ALFA. Here you can get additional background information about the project, information about the latest release, how the data is generated in QC, how to access the data, along with tutorials and past presentations. Next, I will demonstrate how to search and explore dbSNP for variants of interest. We'll be going over contents also available on dbSNP handout guide, which you can download from the homepage and review at your convenience. You can click here to download the handout PDF. For today's demonstration, we'll be going over how to search and display the records, how to use the preset filters to refine and explore your results, how to download the data. We will also be covering the variant summary information that is available for each SNP record. We'll go over in details the ALFA allele frequency table on the RefSNP page. There are additional topics in the handout that we won't be covering today, but you can review them at your convenience by downloading this PDF. For today's search demonstration, we will be using the breast cancer gene BRCA1. The total number of records returned is shown here. The first 20 is shown. You can page to the result using these navigation buttons or change your default display settings. Summary information is provided for each record, including the variant type, the alleles and flanks, the position of GRC38 and GRCH37, the variant notation and SPEDI and HVS format, the gene that the variant is mapped to, in this case is BRCA1, our search term, the functional consequence and position-based annotations, ClinVar clinical significance, the validation status, and the minor allele frequency. Reported is the minor allele, its frequency, and allele count for ALFA and many different other projects for you to compare across projects and different populations. In this case, the variant we're looking at, it appeared to be a common variant as reported consistently across all populations and all projects. And also, it is reported as B9 in ClinVar. If we're interested in looking at pathogenic variants in BRCA1, we can use the preset filters. With the filter activated, we reduce the result from 26,000 down to 2,600. The result now returned all variant with clinical assertion of pathogenic from ClinVar. However, be aware that there can be multiple assertion from different labs and submitters from ClinVar. Multiple filters can be applied at the same time to further reduce down your results. So we'll select for a variant that has alpha allele frequency to look at the correlation between allele frequency and the clinical assertion. The result shows that for variant with pathogenic assertion, most of them appear to be rare. You can select as many filters as you would like. And once you have your results, you can select specific record or download everything. You can also clear all the filters to return to the original results. You can take a look at the variant detail report by clicking on the RS number here, or to examine the frequency in more details by clicking this link here. The link takes you to the frequency tab on the rest of the page that has the allele frequency details. Shown here is the total allele counts and the reference and alpha allele frequency as total for the project and for each of the subpopulations. The columns are sortable, so you can order the data according to your preference, or you can limit the number of rows shown by typing into the search box. Shown below the alpha frequency table is the frequency from all the other projects that are available in dbSNP, including the 1,000 genome, NOMAD, and many others. You can limit the display to a particular population by typing in the search box. In this case, it's African. And we did compare the reporting across all different projects. You can also download the data in tab delimited format by clicking on the download button. While on the RefSip page, you can explore other tabs, doing the very detail with the map and information, clinical significance, publications, and flanks. In addition to searching by gene, you can search for dbSNP and ALFA data using RS numbers, genomic location, clinical significance, and allele frequency range. Additional terms are also available here. We're now back at the ALFA homepage. Next, we'll go over the demonstration how to access dbSNP and ALFA data using the API. You can get access to the Python Jupyter notebooks by clicking on any of the links under the tutorial sections. The link will take you to the source code on GitHub for the Jupyter notebook. For today's demonstration, we'll run these interactively online on Binder. To do that, navigate up to the Jupyter Notebook directory. Under there, you will find notebooks for the ALFA project with methods to retrieve the data by using gene, RSID, and other methods. There are links to launch the notebook and run them interactively online. We will launch the notebook to retrieve the frequency data by gene. In this tutorial, we'll be retrieving the frequency for the gene TP53. To do that, we employ two functions. One, to retrieve the genomic location of TP53, and then using those locations to retrieve the frequency. After initialization of the function to get the gene location, we can then call it to get by using the gene ID to get the CoLab session and the start and stop position. And then print out the output. We'll run it now. The output shows the URL that was used to call the gene database using the gene ID to get the chromosome accession and start and stop position for the gene. With the position, we could then use to call the ALFA frequency service to get all the variants and their frequencies within that range. To get the variant, we'll initialize a little helper function to iterate through the range. And then this is the main function that retrieves the variance by sequence interval. So with the chromosome accession, start and stop position as input, we'll run it now. So it's iterating through and retrieving 250 variant at a time. And this is the actual URL or API call to the variation service to retrieve the variants. Then it's printed out the final result, the final count. The example that we just went over used the gene as input to query the ALFA frequency database. There's also an example for using the RSID or VCF as input. There's also an example for querying the metadata and to graph the frequency. And the last one we'll go over is how to query the ALFA VCF that is hosted on NCBI FTP site. We'll launch that example now. This demonstration makes use of the Python Tabex module to retrieve the data from the VCF that's hosted on NCBI FTP site. So with just a few lines of codes, we can retrieve the frequency data for ALFA. We query for a single location, so return a single row from the VCF. We contain the standard VCF report of chromosome, position, variant ID, alleles, and then followed by the allele count for each population. This notebook is interactive, so we can try to change it to a range and rerun it. So now we return all the rows within that range. There are optional functions to retrieve the metadata, to format the report in more human readable format, if you want to check it out on your own. With that, this concludes the demonstration, and I will take any questions that you may have.